The three-month of a grueling day-long cross-examinations at the expense of the taxpayer during the 75 sittings of the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament investigating the colossal theft at Postal Building now tantamounts to zero. According to this letter written by Director of Public Prosecutions Richard Butera to Speaker Rebecca Litwala Kadaga on the 6th of this month, the probe is prejudicial owing to duplication of witnesses appearing before it with those appearing in court. Coincidentally, it was penned the same day on which First Lady Jenica Taha Museveni declined to appear before the Public Accounts Committee.
Speaker's letter was to the effect that the Public Accounts Committee halts its work until such a time when the cases have been concluded or as otherwise further directed. The way I look at it betrays the Committee of Parliament. It's a betrayal. 3 months down the road, you make people really have sleepless nights.
Now, what is confusing the Speaker and the DPP is that they think that our recommendations as Public Accounts Committee will be used to prosecute. No.
This report might never come out. And by the time it will come out, it might not be very useful to us.
In her defense for countering a decision certified by her deputy, Jacob Olanya, who had earlier ruled that all accounting officers are accountable to Parliament, Kadaga quotes a rule of procedure number 64, which she says any matter before court is subjudicial and barred from debate in Parliament. Legislators, however, questioned the prudence of using the rules of procedure to challenge the Constitution.
We have spent 3 solid months meeting. And in every meeting that we sit in, there is water, there is tea. That is a cost. No, we must account to our people. That is a cost.
I'm wondering why she has taken that decision, because we should follow the Constitution more than the rules of procedure.
According to DPP's letter directing Parliament to hold any inquiries into OPM officials till a court finishes its investigations, some witnesses the committee was seeking, like a key fraud suspect, a principal accountant, Godfrey Kazinda, and up to 40 truck drivers who refuted reports that they consumed a fuel worth 6 billion Ugandan shillings, among others, are all appearing in court. Kassiano, however, calls it a betrayal by government on the fight against corruption, adding that he cannot rule out undue pressure from some of the suspects who are yet to appear before the committee.
Why it has taken 3 months down the road for this issue to come, and more particularly at a time when we have had bad blood, as it were, flowing between the executive and the parliament, cannot make me have a closed mind without opening it up to auras of suspicion.
So if one arm of government is doing something, and in their view they are doing it efficiently, then there's no problem, because all of it is serving the public interest.
The committee chairman, Kassiano Wadri, however, says the committee will not trash its findings, but will proceed and produce a report containing all that has been unearthed prior to the injunction, which will be handed over to the House.